In this video, we're going to talk about stress breakers, in particular, those that apply to crowns and bridges, and we're going to cover three or four different models. Talk to me about stress breakers. Firstly, what are they? How do they work?
Well, very simply, if you were missing a tooth, a lot of times what would happen would be the two adjacent teeth would be prepped.
This is a little bit back in the day we're talking about this technique.
Absolutely, but it's still used a lot of times when an implant is not the correct treatment modality.
Okay.
So we still do make a lot of three-unit bridges in dentistry. And where a stress breaker comes into play is if these teeth are not parallel or cannot take a full bridge, they're segmented into two pieces,
right,
with a stress breaker to connect the two.
Okay, so it's almost like sort of a flexible coupling to some extent.
Well, it doesn't flex, but it allows independent seating.
Right.
So you can seat one side first. On this side, you can seat the crown first. You have
right.
The male attachment on the crown. Female is inside the ponic, So you do not see that. Seat the crown, then you seat the ponic and the rest of the bridge on top. So you can seat these independently of each other.
How are these components here attached to this process?
So this is the FR attachment. It's a very unique attachment where there's a prefabricated male that's metal. Mm-hmm. There's a plastic female. Lost wax technique is utilized to fabricate the bridge. But what's unique about the FR attachment as a stress breaker is that the male is placed into the plastic female during casting. So the female is cast against the male, which makes sure that the male has a fully intimate fit with a female.
Okay, that makes more sense. So these are those wax components.
Correct.
That are used in the molding process.
Yes, cross wax technique.
Now we have quite a few things to look at here. What are some of the others?
So taking that segmenting idea a step further, this is more of a traditional idea, male and female PD or dovetail attachment, rounded, contoured, makes it nice and smooth, easy for the technician to work with, a mandrel on each side. So the whole idea of a mandrel on each side is if you're working in the mandible flexes, we don't want to have the female in the crown and the male in the ponic because that would wedge down tighter as the mandible flexes.
Okay.
Whereas if we invert the bridge, something like this, we put the male on the ponic, I'm sorry, the male in the crown, the female in the ponic, this allows it to move as the mandible flexes.
Okay, that makes sense.
Third one is going to be, again, as we move towards the anterior of the mouth where the crowns and the teeth are taller, narrower, unlike the PD design that was shorter and wider, we need something that's long and narrow. This is a splintastic attachment, 1.2 millimeters and 0.8 millimeters in diameter. This is placed between the two anterior crowns. There's a very smooth ceramic insert that's placed into the female during casting to make sure the female stays smooth. And again, when you're splinting the anterior, it's so that you can get independent draw, seating, and strength.
And these are then covered with ceramics as part of the last part of the process.
Absolutely. So the third stress breaker, when we're talking about stress breakers, would be using a hinge. You have a trunnion and the hinge beneath. Now the hinge allows independent movement.
Is this sort of an up-to-date technique or a little bit old school?
We don't see as many partial dentures, but I think this is something that's definitely underutilized in technology right now. I think this can save a lot of abutment teeth. Because if you think about what happens when a patient loses the teeth in the posterior, they don't have the blood flow, they don't have the stimulus, the bone continues to resorb, and unless they come in every 12 months and check for a reline, reline meaning establishing the support for the acrylic saddles to that bone and tissue, there's going to be a hinge movement when they lose that bone. One of the things we can do to protect that is by having a hinge incorporated in our partial frameworks that helps protect that tooth. Because if we have too much of that movement, it becomes a fulcrum and just rocks that abutment tooth out. So hinges are very nice and easy to work with. And again, this can be used to protect our abutment teeth in any partial denture design used in conjunction with attachments. And again, as the patient functions, as they lose bone, as they lose that supportive soft tissue, that hinge will help protect the abutment tooth. Simple, old school technique, but I really think it's underutilized today.
All right, cool. Anything else we should know about stress breakers, particularly when it comes to crowns and bridges?
You know, in general, we're going to use a PD or a keyway in the posterior, shorter, wider attachments for the shorter, wider teeth. We're going to use a rod and tube in the anterior, taller, narrower teeth. We're going to try and set these stress breakers so that we don't see them, to provide maximum aesthetics, but still allowing us to restore the case.
All right, it makes a lot of sense. If you'd like to find out more, please head over to Preat.com, where there's loads of knowledge and information, hundreds of case presentations. Of course, you can order all of these components if you'd like to. Also, you can get in touch with our technical team or customer support for more detailed information. You can do that via email. You can do that via our live chat function. Of course, you can call us up old school with an actual phone. Looking forward to seeing you at Preat.com.